Good morning, children. My name is Gopal Dubey and I'm an educator at World Peace School in Indore. Today we are going to study figure of speech. We have already studied parts of speech. Parts of speech mein humne kya padha tha? In parts of speech we have studied noun, pronoun, adverb, adjective. Okay. Now in figure of speech we are studying simile. We are going to study simile, metaphor, personification, oxymoron, about hundreds of figure of speech is there in English language. Yes, it's more than 100 of figure of speech. We will not study all the figure of speech. Now the question arises, what is figure of speech and why it is used in English language? See, figure of speech is used for the beautification. It is also called as a figurative speech, and English is a beautiful language. Okay, now the question arises, कि इंग्लिश कैसे ब्यूटीफुल हो सकती है? इट्स अ लैंग्वेज. हाउ कैन इट बी अ ब्यूटीफुल? कोई ऑब्जेक्ट, कोई थिंग ब्यूटीफुल होती है? नॉट अ लैंग्वेज, इट कैन नॉट बी. बट फ्रॉम फिगर ऑफ स्पीच यू विल कम टू नो दैट हाउ ब्यूटीफुल इंग्लिश इज. ओके, फॉर द मोर डेकोरेटिव वे ऑफ योर सेंटेंसेस, फॉर मोर इम्पैक्टफुल, टू मेक मोर इम्पैक्टफुल सेंटेंसेस और टू रीड और टू कैप्चर द रीडर्स, टू कैप्चर द रीडर्स point of view or to capture readers towards yourself, we make English more beautified by figure of speech. So come to figure of speech now. Simile and metaphor. We will study simile and metaphor in a comparison way only, because a very slight difference is there between simile and metaphor. Ha. See, simile and metaphor, from the example we'll come to know about it. For example, if I write, he fought bravely. Example number one. Example number two, he fought like a lion. Okay. Example number three, he was a lion in the fight. All the three sentences denoting the same fight and the same person. But what is the comparison? What is different? See, he fought bravely. Simple sentence, very ordinary language. A simple sentence is he fought bravely. Okay, अच्छा fight किया उसने and he won, whatever it is. Now he fought like a lion. Now I am comparing a person to a lion. Is it possible कि कोई fight में lion हो सकता है? No, it is not. So we are comparing to make the sentence more impactful. Now in third sentence, what I'm going to do, he was a lion in the fight. Now this is the direct comparison. Usko lion hi bol diya fight mein. He was a lion in the fight. So a person cannot be a lion. We all know it very well. But what we are doing, if we use like and as, what do you mean by like and as? Like and as means uski tarah. If we use like and as, it denotes simile. It denotes simile. When there is like and as, there is a simile, meaning this sentence contains a simile. This sentence contains a simile. And he was a lion, matlab usko usse compare, direct comparison. Where there is a direct comparison, it is a metaphor. When there is a direct comparison, it is a metaphor. So he fought bravely was a simple sentence, normal language, which we already used in English language. If we want to beautify our sentence, we use simile or metaphor. A very slight difference between simile and metaphor. It's very confusing that if we are using like and as, it will be simile. And when we are directly comparing a person with some other object or jo nahi ho sakta usse, then it is a metaphor. I hope it is clear. Now second example, come to second example. He ran slowly. It's a very simple sentence. Example one, he ran slowly. Yes, okay. But dheere bhaga, it's okay. He ran like a tortoise. Now I'm comparing a person with a tortoise. We all know tortoise bhagta nahi hai, chalta hai dheere dheere, dheere dheere chalta hai. So we are comparing a person to a tortoise, meaning we are comparing something. Like is there, so it will be a simile here again. Okay, now he is a tortoise in the race. If I say he is a tortoise, direct comparison of a person to a tortoise, usko tortoise hi bol diya, then what is this? It is a metaphor. There is no like and no as, so it is a metaphor. When there is a direct comparison is there, it is metaphor. So simile and metaphor is completed. I hope you understand with these examples. You can see the videos as for more understandings. I'll send you some videos as well. Now come to personification. What is personification? When we put qualities in a non-living thing, living ki qualities jab hum non-living mein dal dete hain, usko bolte hain personification. It denotes that it is about a person. Person ki qualities kisi non-living se compare karna, it's personification to beautify your sentence, to make it more impactful, to make it more impressive. Readers ka attention capture karne ke liye, we use all these figures of speech and personification is one of them. So, from the example we can come, the fire engulfed the whole forest. We can here use swallow as well as an easy word. Engulf matlab the fire engulf ya fire swallow the whole forest. Ab aag to pura forest nahi kha sakti na. From the sentence you can understand that. But we are comparing the fire from swallowing. Swallowing is a verb. It's an activity. It's a verb. So activity can't be done from a non-living object. Fire cannot engulf the forest. But we are comparing with how disastrous the fire was. So we are comparing the fire with that disaster. So we are using personification here that the fire engulfs or it swallows the whole forest. Second example we'll come to know. The whole town was sleeping. Is it possible the town is sleeping? Town is a non-living thing. It is a non-living thing. It is not possible the town is sleeping, but we are comparing that how much silence was there in the town, that there was nobody was there when we were seeing it or where we were there. So the town was sleeping. We are comparing the non-living thing with an action with a verb. Sleeping is a verb over here. It's an action word. So we are comparing something with a non-living thing to make it more impactful. It is called as personification. I hope personification is clear to you all. Come to oxymoron. Today we will end up with oxymoron. Oxymoron is a speech in which two words contradict. Okay, two opposite words ka ek hi speech mein use karna simultaneously is called as oxymoron. Pretty ugly. If I say she is pretty ugly. Now what do you mean by it's pretty is something beautiful and ugly is not beautiful. Okay, ugly is the opposite of pretty. But you can pretty ugly, pretty ke do meaning hote hain. Pretty is thoda sa or pretty is you're beautiful. So when one word is containing two or more meanings is called as a oxymoron. Like he was found missing. Found and missing, both contradictory words. But found ka kya meaning hota hai? Kuch mil jana aur ho jana. Found, missing. Matlab isme kya matlab hua iska? He was found missing matlab wo खो गया या खोया हुआ पाया गया. पाया गया इज फाउंड एंड कुछ चीज मिल जाना इज ऑल्सो फाउंड. नाउ नेचुरल एक्टिंग. आई एम सेइंग नेचुरल ऑल्सो एंड आई एम सेइंग एक्टिंग ऑल्सो. टू कॉन्ट्रोडिक्टरी वर्ड्स. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ऑक्सीमोरोन. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो दीज फोर फिगर ऑफ स्पीच. थैंक यू फॉर नाउ.